Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, we're running a little sample of copper chops through our 4x8 shaker table. You can see we got it set up here. It's a little bit goofy. It's got the plastic on top to break the surface tension. Well, let's go take a look at the sample we're running, and I'll show you the results. Okay, here's your sample of copper chops. We're going to run it on our 4x8 shaker table here, and I know this looks silly, but I used the very thin plastic sheet to break the surface tension. And what happens is it allows the copper to settle down on the table and not float away, especially the fine stuff here. Because I think there's a little bit of oil or something on there that makes it float and hydrophobic. So the plastic breaks the surface tension and it just works its way all the way down the table. You can see it here. Into the concentrates over here, and then all the plastic is light enough that it just gets washed down with the water. I've weighed our bucket. It's 37 pounds. I'm going to take 2 pounds away for the weight of the bucket. So I have 35 pounds of material here, and I'll figure out how much copper I get after we're done. So I'm running your sample here. It really helps to get it wet first, so to mix it with a little bit of water. I'll try and do two things at once here, but goes into the little feed trough. There's all the little gates. Everything's flowing out these little holes in the aluminum trough onto the table. All your insulation is coming down clean. There's no copper in there. And then over here, all your clean copper is coming out. The aluminum is down here. And it's working its way across the shaker table. The aluminum, for the most part, is coming into the number 2, some down into the number 3, but very little is coming down into the number 2. Almost everything's coming down into the number 1. That's your pretty much clean copper. Tinned wires in there. A few little aluminum flakes are getting down in there, but I think you can tune the table a little bit better, increase the water flow to push those aluminum pieces down into the number 2 or the number 3. But it just works very well. And you just kind of want a nice even feed rate. Set up a little feeder here or something to do this automatically. But it goes down into the, you can see it separates pretty much right in the trough. The copper's going along in the bottom and all the insulation is floating on top. So I'll feed this through and we'll weigh our copper at the end. I just stopped feeding. Here's the clean insulation. There's a few little pieces of copper that I've spilled on top of the plastic. But if you look down through, there's no copper there. Everything's coming over here. See the small wires starting to float when I take the plastic sheet off. There's your big old band of copper. Runs right down underneath there. All the way to here. There's so much copper coming off this table, it's kind of clogging up my number 1 port here, so I got to keep running over and cleaning it out. But look at all that nice clean copper coming out of there. And then it's just working its way in a big old band down the table. Our bucket here is almost full. Let me go get another bucket. Well, I just finished up the last of it. Here's another shot of our clean insulation going down into the number four. A big wide band of copper. The aluminum is separating out, running down pretty much into the number two. We'll take a look. I expect the number two has a little bit of copper and aluminum in it, so you could probably just rerun through the granulator again. And then here's this band of copper coming down here. Oh, we're clogged up again. It works really good. I'm always impressed by how clean the copper comes. There's our second tub there. There's our first one. And there's hardly anything in this number two. So I'll let the table finish up here and then we'll take a look at what we got. We'll get our weights. And here's a look at what we ended up with. So this is our number one concentrates. Pretty much pure copper. I think this would easily be classified number two because it's got the tinned wire in there and the finer wire size. Just a little, every once in a while, there's a little flake of aluminum, but I think that's well within the spec for number two copper. Here is all that we caught in our number two concentrates. Some aluminum, a little bit of copper, mostly tin stuff, real fine stuff. It kind of rat's nests up and wads up. There's hardly anything there. And you probably just throw that back in the granulator again and chop it up and run it back on the table. And then here I put a bucket under the number three middlings. And this is mostly just heavy rubber insulation and aluminum. Very, very little copper. Mostly super fine copper wires, if any. And again, maybe you can tune the table a little bit to recover more of that. But man, it's probably not 0.1% of the overall copper in there. And I don't think the aluminum's worth anything to go after. And then whatever else just went into the tub there for recycling the water. But let's get the number one weighed and see how much copper we recovered from 35 pounds. There's our two buckets of number one combined. On the scale, we ended up with 20 pounds. Take away two for the bucket, so you get 18 pounds. Started with 35 pounds of material, so it's pretty much exactly 50% recovery. So thanks guys for watching our video. If you have any questions or comments on the equipment that we ran today, you can find our contact information in the description below, or you can leave me a comment in the comment section. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.